Hey, has this ever happened to you? You've got footage from one camera, and then you got footage from another camera, and then maybe you got some footage from a drone, and then maybe you got some footage from a stock video, and then you look at it and you're about to edit it, and then you realize, oh my God, none of my frame rates match. And that's what I just ran into here, where I've got stuff that's 30 frames per second, some that's 29.97, 24, 23.94, 25, and even 50. And not only that, some of the bit depths are different, some of the frame sizes are different, and none of this stuff actually matches. And so obviously when you put it into Premiere Pro, slap it all together, cut it, edit it, export it, you're gonna get into some situation where you will have choppy video. And this is kind of what I got. You see, horse doesn't move, and then chops to the next scene, and then chops again to the horse, and then we get something smooth again. So I got to the point where I said, well, there's gotta be an easier way to fix this. And guess what? I got it for you. All right, so the solution that I found was that you can either go in and do a lot of tinkering with each little file and see if you can make them all match, but here's a much easier way that I found because, well, after looking on YouTube and looking on Google, I couldn't actually find a solution that was simple. So here's the hack that I did. I've taken all my clips here and put them straight into iMovie, right? That's right, I put all my clips right into iMovie. I let iMovie take care of rendering each of these clips to the size and bit depth and all that other stuff that I really don't have the brain space to understand, and then went to go export it as a file. And I just made it so that instead of using the regular quality, I went ProRes quality and compression, better quality, and export it. And my clips came out looking great. So from there, all I had to do was then go back into Premiere Pro and create a completely new video. And unfortunately, yes, I did start from the very beginning again. I pulled in my full clip that I got from QuickTime, put it in, spliced it, put it together, and then exported it, but no issues whatsoever. Came out buttery smooth and saved me a whole lot of time. All right, that's it. Thanks for watching. If you have any comments, questions, put them below and be sure to click on like, subscribe, and click on that little bell to be notified every time we put up new content. And I am happy to announce that our online real estate photography course is now done and it is ready for you. Just go to www.robmoroto.com and use a coupon code that is in the show notes here to get yourself a nice little discount. All right, see you later.